Are your parents tall as well? My mum's pretty tall. My mum's like 5'9", and my dad's like 6 foot, I reckon. Well, he was in his prime. He's probably a bit shorter now. But my mum's, the men on my mum's side of the family are really tall. When I say really tall, they're like 6'2". I've got a cousin on my mum's side is 6'3". I'm the tallest in my family, though. Viking jeans. Yeah, my mum's side is Welsh and Norwegian. My dad's side is English and then trace Irish, German, French, Spanish. When's the next IRL content going to be? I don't know, man. I'm going to be traveling around in December and I'll probably record that and do a whole new channel for it. So we'll see. I was just speaking to Kurt Kaz today about what I wasn't speaking to him. I asked him what equipment he used and he answered me in it. So we're like this, me and Kurt Kaz, dude. You know? Drick has unfollowed you on Twitter, yeah, but on Instagram, no, we're still following. He still follows me. It's all good. Their take on the Ngannou situation, but yeah, they do typically have some very strange takes, don't they? I'm glad my impression video is going down a hit, going down a hoot. I'm getting some good trending. Normally when I do these obscure videos that have nothing to do with a trending topic, it doesn't really get many views, but this one's doing well. Going to hit about 20K views in an hour. I've come a long way, chat. Any OGs in here remember when I was getting like a few K views a video? It wasn't that long ago. I remember if I got like 50K views, I was like, dude, it went viral. Now if I get 50K views, I'm down. I've fallen off. Bro, you weren't working a 9-to-5. Why lie? I was working a 9-to-5. And I slowly worked it down in hours as time went on. But I actually was. Dude, I started streaming in 2018, you know. Don't like you had bathing servants, no. Ariel gets like 5K views. When he doesn't have fighters on, it was with a family friend, so it wasn't a contract thing. It was just flexible. I worked from like full-time, then I took 4 days, 3 days, slowly started working less and less. Then I did half days, so I slowly started doing less and less. Yeah, my original job, though, I did work out the contract. Yeah, I worked it for a year. Worked a 9-to-5 for 6 months and acts like he knows the real world. No, I didn't. I just worked a 9-to-5. I've worked a 9-to-5 for a few years before. What's next for Jan Blachowicz? I would like to see him fight against Jiří in Europe, but they won't do that. But maybe they'll do him versus the winner of Jiří and Jamal Hill. He has to get a top contender. He deserves it. Not going to get a title shot or anything. But he went to... Dude, Jan Blachowicz nearly beat Pereira. When I first watched it, I genuinely thought Jan Blachowicz beat him. And then I rewatched it. I was like, Pereira landed a few more jabs to the body than I remember. But Jan Blachowicz genuinely nearly beat Pereira. Only in hindsight did I watch it and go, Pereira got the third. Watching it live, especially with the takedown at the end for Jan, I was like, man, Pereira's probably going to lose this fight. Dude, Jan Blachowicz, I can't believe this, yeah. He got the takedown in round 3, chat, and he just laid on Pereira doing nothing. I've never seen worse decision. He probably hates himself every day for that, you know. All Jan needed to do was throw some shots, and he absolutely would have got that decision. But he did nothing on top of Pereira in full guard. Absolutely nothing. If he would have just went, just a few more slapping shots that aren't even anything into him, he would have won that fight. He would have got the decision. Shame. Jan kind of got robbed. He didn't know. When you watch it back, Pereira did land a lot more clear shots. But Jan did really well. Jan did really, really well. I thought he won it when I watched it live. So much Copian. It's not a Cope take. I'm a Pereira fan. Thoughts on Umar trying to dictate when him and Marab fight? Yeah, he's just this fucking privileged little Dagestani fuckboy. Bitch. It's annoying. But yeah, I get it. Marab should like look into fight. But like, you don't dictate Marab comes back 3 months later after just winning his fucking belt in September. Wow, Marab, you don't want to fight in December, I see. Like, dude, shut the fuck up. He's just went 5 rounds of O'Malley, you know? He'll come back in, you know, when he wants to come back. And wow, doesn't want to fight in December, and I'm not fighting during Ramadan. Well, that sucks to be you, bruv. You know what I mean? That's not on Marab. You should fight him in fucking February during Ramadan, bitch. Does Umar have personality? Somewhat, yeah. He's getting better when his English gets better. Umar should fight Aldo. It doesn't make sense now. If Aldo would have won, I would have wanted that as a title elimination bout, but we'll see, brother. Maybe the winner of Font Phillips will call him out. If it's Phillips, that'd be more logical. I wouldn't even mind Umar Mario Batista, you know, just for bants. Just because Batista's relevant, because of how hated he is. If Umar put him away, that would give Umar so much fucking stock. As like, yeah, we love Umar, you know? Aldo Cruz. Yeah, do Aldo versus Cruz and then do Aldo versus like O'Malley if he loses again, or Figueiredo if he loses to Yan, some shit like that. Get him right back into the top five. You think you have a better chin than Johnny Walker? I think so, yeah. I've taken some big shots in Muay Thai and that, and I haven't been chinned. But obviously, I haven't been hit by these fucking... No. I can't say I have. But I don't think I'm getting chinned as often as him if I was a trained fighter. I think he has got a... Yes or no, chat, just a genetically bad chin. Walker. You know? Some people's bodies just don't react right to being hit, and he's one of them. Like, even though we're not as good of fighters and we probably would get chinned a lot easier because we're not fucking trained fighters, his chin is not built to withstand damage. Like, classic glass jaw, weird gene that is just a problem for him, you know? Terrible D, yeah, defense, leaves himself wide open, true. He does. He always gets hit straight in the fucking face with his hands nowhere near his chin. Do you in the UK care about Conor Benn and Eubank? Yeah. Eblin's so overrated, yeah. What would you consider the safer bet? Ilia, KO, or Max decision? Probably a Max decision. Nah, Ilia by KO. I really think Ilya's going to get him and chin him. I have a true belief in that. I think Ilia might... Yes or no, chat? They start getting scrappy and, like, gritty. I can see Ilia mixing in takedowns at the end of some of the rounds. I think that's where the difference is going to be made. I don't think he's going to be shying away from going for takedowns. He will go for them. If he cracks Holloway, he'll mix it in after. Like, he will go for takedowns. He's got good takedowns. Hope Ilia gets that KO. Do you think he'll get it even though he didn't against Josh Emmett? He damn near nearly had it against Josh Emmett, and Emmett's really fucking hard to finish. I think he'll get the KO. I think Holloway's just too tall and coming back down to featherweight after a while off. I know he hasn't KO'd others before, but that's never been a reason to just say, oh, that means he won't KO this guy. Ilya's massively improving. I've got Ilia, man. I've got a real feeling about it. If we're saying how wow, I know, dude. Yeah, Ilia KOs Holloway and all of a sudden it's Emmett, the second best in the division. Ugh, God. Topuria, you goblin freak. Do you not understand Ilia the Rat has not fought anyone besides a compromised Volkov, a KO? But he looks so good, so technically good at boxing. I think he's going to be able to crack Holloway. Put it this way, he looks better than any way Arnold Allen had looked technically as a fighter in a stand-up department. Leading into the Holloway fight. And Allen nearly beat Holloway. He didn't know he lost round one. But he did good. He landed good shots. Max won more rounds against Volk. Yeah, because Ilya was only in one completed round against Volk. That is the stupidest argument I've ever heard. And he made it competitive. I know, but in rounds 2, 4, and 5, Allen was doing good. And I think that Ilia has looked better up until that. Listen, you can't have picked, oh, how can you pick Ilia to beat Volk? You just, all he did is beat Emmett. Sometimes you have to pick these guys, you know? I know, Ilia slept Volk. I know, but Volk was compromised, I think, coming into the fight, but still happened. People forget, man, Arnold Allen's a marauder. Like, Alan took Yusuf to a 29-28 split decision. I'm confident Ilia would KO Sadiq Yusuf. You know? Alan took... I mean, a Calvin Kattar fight was an injury, but Alan was still doing well in that fight. I think Ilia would have done the same thing to that featherweight version of Dan Hooker. Yeah, Alan was nowhere on paper anywhere close to Max. But he did good in the fight, really good in the fight. And Holloway had to pick at range with kicks and that. I used to be so bullish on Kattar. I used to think Kattar was the real deal as well before the Holloway fight. But I still picked Holloway to beat him. But yeah. Alan was close until that knockdown. He was. He was. What were the stats anyway in that fight? I'm bulletproof. Because I never had guitar lessons. I taught myself, but I had drumming lessons when I was younger. They were trying to convince me to stay in school, so they let me do drumming lessons during some of the free periods that I had, because I just kept leaving. See ya! Dude, I used to be a G back in school, dude. They in sixth form, yeah, they used to do this thing where they would basically give you two periods of lessons at the start of the day, 3 hours free with nothing going on, and then like a period at the end of the day for an hour where they'd expect you to stick around and come back. Anyone who's been in sixth form in the UK knows about this. Dude, as soon as the first two periods were done, see ya, walked out of school, dude. You're allowed to leave school in sixth form, basically, to go get drinks and go to the shop. And you're allowed to wander around. And I'd just be like, see you, dude. Bye. I had like 40% attendance at the end of the second year. It was kind of bad, to be honest with you. But, you know, it's all good. At least this YouTube thing worked out. Boys, I would have been cooked. I would have been cooked in a real world. Thank God this YouTube thing worked out. Jesus Christ. Fucking hell, man. I left. Yeah, I literally just used to ditch. That's why you're retarded. No, I had maths at A level, yeah. But I'd have like, what did I do? I don't leak too much. But I had like lessons at the start of the day. And then they would give you like two periods of nothing. And then at the end of the day after lunch, they'd expect you to come back for the last lesson. I just used to leave every time. All the time. Skipping lessons. In the UK, do they call your parents when you're absent? No, no. No, they don't. There's no legal obligation, but you're not supposed to. But they do. They do call your parents, but not really. If you don't show up to any lesson after you sign in, then they do. But they just stopped calling the parents for me. They do if you're under 17. Yeah, exactly. But in sixth form, you're over. You're 17 and over. 17, 18.